All right, welcome back. This is the last part of this series. And here I want to show you as a continuation to what I showed you about Power BI, that once I have uploaded my Excel file, or if I used another tool to build a model, but I have a model already in Power BI, I've built my dashboards and reports, I can use them not only from the browser, but also from mobile devices. So I brought two with me, and I'm going to use them to show you the experience from first an iPad and then an iPhone. So let us switch to seeing my, I have this contraption here, the cable connecting directly to video, and we are live from the iPad. So I can click on, I see the list of my dashboard. I already logged in. I am authenticated against the same tenant with my Microsoft account, and I click on one of the dashboards, the dashboard that we saw before. So now we see the same thing. We see that actually the additional one, we actually see two similar parts, which is good because we see that actually this is the way the dashboard was edited by me a few minutes ago when I recorded the previous model, when I showed you Power BI from the browser. When I click on any one of those, I can go into this single chart or single tile experience. For example, you see I'm with my finger, I'm moving between the elements on top. Every time I'm parking on one of them, it shows the details for this one. But I can also, I can annotate and start creating some comments. I can share this with some other people, but I can also open the report behind it. So it's a similar experience, but just interesting. Let's try again. I selected one of the tiles and I clicked on the open the report. Yeah, here it is. So now I see the report with all the different visualizations, and you see that actually this was actually a map, but now last time I touched it, I made it into a column chart, which is, again, it could be a map. Believe me, this could be visualized as a map in the same way. But again, when I touch it, it actually filters all others. And I touch it again, it goes back. I can also touch this one, and in the same way, it will affect all the others. So I have this report effect, and I can also uncheck one of the years and select another year. So all the interactivity on the report that I had from the browser is also available for me here on this device. I'm using here an iPad. Similar experience will be from a Android-based tablet or a Windows-based tablet. With the same kind of functionality, but when I say the same, it's actually same, but adjusted to take advantage of the capabilities of each one platform individually. Now let me switch to my little brother here. So we have a smaller form factor, which is an iPhone 6. So the same cable I am just connecting to the iPhone 6, holding this in my hand, and now let's see what this the experience on the iPhone looks. You see here, I already logged in, I authenticated, and I see the different dashboards that are available for me, either that I created them or that were shared with me by their corresponding authors. Now, because of the form factor, we cannot really show all the visualizations as a grid of tiles. We show them just as one dimensional list of tiles going left to right, row by row. So, but I see all the visualizations that were part of this chart, this dashboard. Now, when I choose one of the tiles, I can use this tool here to move this line, to move between the elements and to see more details. What I don't have from the phone because it's not practical, is a way to dive into the report. So in the iPhone, I'm left just at the level of looking at the different elements of the dashboard. And when I click on one of them, I can see it in more detail, but I cannot go and see the report experience. Now, the Power BI is rapidly evolving, and the team behind Power BI is adding new features in a very rapid cadence. Every month, you will see new functionality coming. So also the mobile applications will update and will show you different, more functionality and more visualizations and more gestures that you will be used. You could use against the visualizations. But I hope you got a more complete understanding of what the offering of Power BI. You can upload data models either with Excel or built by other tools like Power BI Desktop. Once you have a model, you can start creating dashboards and reports. You can also interact with them with this natural English questions that we saw. And then finally, you can use a variety of phones and tablets, Android, Windows, or iOS devices to interact with the reports and the dashboard, share them with your colleagues, and get the full benefit of having a cloud-based solution available on a variety of devices. So this concludes our series, and I hope that you are now enthused enough and you are interested to learn more, and it will provide you with more materials to learn from, and we'd like also to hear from you. Thank you.